Greetings. This video refutes argument number 5 from the random flood list sent by the Mohammedan. Let's look at the claim. 5. According to Bible, Jesus your God used to sleep, Matthew 8:23. But according to Muhammad's Quran, God can't sleep, Quran 2:255. Really? Is this really what they teach at the madrasa? Is this really the kind of argument that convinces you to follow Muhammad into an eternity he knew nothing about? So be it. According to Bible, Jesus your God used to sleep. Let's look at it in context. Matthew 8:21. Another of his disciples said, Lord, first let me return home and bury my father. But Jesus told him, follow me and let the dead bury their own dead. And when he got into the boat, his disciples followed him. Wait a minute, that was 8:23. According to Bible, Jesus your God used to sleep, Matthew 8:23. Oh, that's right. Mohammedans care so little for anything accurate, honest, factual, or truthful. They never worry or bother themselves with things like verse numbers or those bothersome words or context. The mention of Jesus sleeping is actually in the next verse. And behold, there arose a great storm on the sea, so that the boat was being swamped by the waves. But he was asleep. So it is 8:24 that mentions Jesus was asleep, at peace, on the boat. According to Bible, Jesus your God used to sleep. And there really are multiple things this verse presents. If you keep reading, for example, you will see that Jesus calms the waves, proving he is Yahweh, God. Not jumping right out at you? Then you've never watched my channel video. Psalms 89:8. O Lord God Almighty, who is like you? You are mighty, O Lord, and your faithfulness surrounds you. You rule the raging of the sea. When its waves rise, you still them. Go back to Matthew 8. So the disciples came and woke him up, saying, Lord, save us, we're going to die. And he said to them, why are you afraid, O ye of little faith? Then he rose and rebuked the winds and the sea, and there was a great calm. The men were amazed and asked, what kind of man is this? Even the wind and sea obey him. O Lord God, you rule the raging of the sea. When its waves arise, you still them. But the men marveled, saying, what manner of man is this that even the winds and the sea obey him? What manner of man, what kind of man is Jesus that even the wind and waves obey him? And that fulfillment of Prophet David's Psalms gets completely lost on a person from Islam because they only want a childish argument. May Almighty God, the Lord God of Israel, allow you to see him revealed by Prophet David in the Psalms. Remember, the whole twisted, misguided point of this Mohammedan's list is to try and mock the Word of God. Remember, he is trying to claim the Quran is better than the Bible, the Word of God. And he thinks that if he can blind you with a snowstorm of feathers, you will surrender to Islam's stupidity. Keep that in mind as we check his references and his statements and his faulty logic. His basic argument is that the Muhammad's Allah is special because the Quran says he cannot sleep. But according to Muhammad's Quran, God can't sleep. Maybe it's only me, but that just sounds like one more thing Allah cannot do. But according to Muhammad's Quran, God can't sleep. I wonder if this Mohammedan bothered. Okay, I could pretty safely bet my life he didn't. See what the rest of the Bible says about God sleeping. Psalms 121, verses 3 through 4. He will not let you stumble. The one who watches over you will not slumber. Behold, he who keeps Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. Now, this is too subtle for Mohammedans. But those of you who have not turned off your brains may see the difference. Psalms 121 says, will not. The Quran says Allah cannot. Read Psalms 121 again. He will not let you stumble. The one who watches over you will not slumber. Behold, he who keeps Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. Will not slumber, shall neither slumber nor sleep. Compare that with the Quran. But according to Mohammed's Quran, God can't sleep. Now, to be fair, Mohammedans do not learn to read for comprehension. So let's look up some of the translations of Surah 2:255 and see what the Quran really says. And to keep this reasonable, I'm only going to look at the phrase associated with Allah sleeping. Asad, neither slumber overtakes him nor sleep. Pickthall, neither slumber nor sleep overtaketh him. Shakir, slumber does not overtake him nor sleep. Al-Karai, neither drowsiness befalls him nor sleep. Ahmed, slumber or sleep never reaches him. The Munshay, neither drowsiness nor sleep ever seizes him. Now, to be perfectly honest, the Quran makes no claim that is unique or different from the Bible in this regard. The Quran does not say that Allah cannot sleep. It really seems to carry the meaning that sleep cannot overpower Allah. And while that appears to defuse the Allah cannot problem for Islam, it does not really excuse the willful ignorance exhibited by the list. Why do Mohammedans lie in their claims and dawa? I mean, you are free to believe Allah is an impotent insomniac if you really want to. But none of the English translations of the Quran imply cannot or use that word. And that begs the question, why lie about something like this? Or do you really want to believe that Mohammedans are simply so stupid they cannot read and comprehend? And as much fun as it is, and as easy as it is to make Islam look stupid, the real point is to open the eyes of the Mohammedans blinded by the lies of Satan. But as you think of the situation of the poor Mohammedan, there are only two options plausible besides bold-faced lying. There is bold-faced lying, there is too stupid to read and comprehend, and there is so deceived they are incapable of free thought. Christians, you need to pray for Muslims and pray that God will shine His light in their eyes, personally. So we've covered several major problems with this claim. The Bible states God will not sleep, implying He could. He is able to. The Quran basically says that sleep cannot overpower Allah, leaving us to wonder why Islam would lie and impugn Allah's ability to sleep. And then we have Jesus. The argument from Islam is basically the childishly oversimplified, Allah cannot sleep, Jesus slept, therefore Jesus can't be Allah. And most Islamic thinking, hey, stop laughing, demonstrates it simply cannot grasp more complicated subjects. And that does boil down to the deception by the father of lies that is sending them to hell while they yell Allahu Akbar. Like I said, and then we have Jesus. Jesus could and did sleep. And rather than disproving his divine origins, his sleeping serves to actually prove his complete emptying of his divinity. God came to earth as a man, and walked and ate and slept. Which always leads to, who ran the universe when Jesus, God, died? But that is another stupid Islamic misunderstanding for another video. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, who calmed the waves after waking up from a refreshing nap on the boat. Amen.